Hello, welcome to Fallout 76. Now, this guide will be a farming and cooking guide and will almost be like a continuation to the guide about your base building. So, you really need to build your base near a water source, and the plants you'll most likely plant are the mud fruits, a lot of them, corn, tattoo plants, and also some cranberries or blackberries actually. Blackberries, you can plant cranberries. And also gourds. Well, maybe you want to place some melons as well. Well, they're here, but they're invisible. So once you get your water production started, you really need to make your crops work. Because as I said in the other video, you can get into a really nasty downward spiral in this game where you don't have food, you don't have water, you don't have anything to do, you just sit and wait. You need a water pump to get dirty water, which you turn into boiled water. And now, I won't speak about all the recipes, I'll just mention the ones that are the most important ones. So, the first thing you should do is use your corn, mud fruits and tattoo plants to make vegetable starch to get adhesive. This is really important, I mean, you don't have to farm a lot for it, you just have to craft it in your base, at your own pace. Now, all the food you see meat and plants alike, so you just go to the plants one. Again, they are pretty good, all of them are pretty good, depends on your preferences, but as a side note, the brain fungus soup is pretty nice, but the glowing fungus, what is it? The glowing fungus soup also gives you red resistance, and the most important food in the game right now is the cranberry relish, because it will give you 10% bonus experience now. If you are 10% with the 5% you get from sleeping and another 5% from the food you get, that soup you get when you play the game sometimes. I don't know what's the way to get it, but again, you will get it and that's 5% more experience. So you really need to craft the cranberry relish. And that glowing fungus puree or soup, depending on what you need or what you're fighting. The other ones are pretty good as well. Okay, this is the one that I wanted to show you. The slit bean puree has damage resist on it. This is a very good buff again. So you want to have some slit beans in your base growing, and also the spices you will collect. Now, another great thing you want to build in your base and also craft as well are the healing salves. Well, you can't build this in your base, but you get the idea. The other one you can do, and this one you have to collect the blood leaf and the soot flower. 20% HP. So with these things, we'll just head into the field now, because again, there are a lot of recipes to cover and you most likely you won't even use all of them, but these are the most important ones. You have to go into flatwoods. It's pretty close to your base anyway. The first time you start, you can get some. Because food weighs a lot in this game, especially the crops, so you can't really haul them all over the map. So it's better to plant them in your base. When you start the game, just craft a few things up, get some food in you, get some extra food and water, and go on an adventure. The extra experience will help you a lot to level up faster, and well, the food will also help you to heal. So now we're in Flatwoods, because the producers made the game have all the best things in Flatwoods or near it. Go to the south of the map. And here we'll have to pick some fertilizer and also the mud fruit plants and some tattoo. Quite a lot of things, quite a lot of good things. So to plant a crop or a fruit, you will need fertilizer, and that one is pretty hard to get, because you won't get it if you don't search for it. It's very rare to find it, to stumble upon it. So in the south, see, you go from here, and when you reach this place, you go into the back of this trailer building. And here you'll find 6 potato plants, and you'll also have... sometimes there is some fertilizer here. And there are also some fruits on the ground, or whatever they are. And by the way... Oh, they killed the Brahmin. Those horrible, horrible people. And then again, you'll just continue down the road and you'll get to here. And you're wondering, why am I doing this? Get the red stag meat. you get 2 stacks of it, and you'll also, again, this is for your beginning of the game. The Rastag meat, after you cook it, now let me show you, because you'll probably do this a lot when you started playing, will give you this great bonus. Carrying capacity, yeah, the biggest problem in the game is related to carrying capacity. Now, where is that thing? Yes, grid last, check it out, 20 weight. That is a lot, believe me, that is a lot, and that will help you a lot. Now, let's go to the mud fruit plant. Again, you can go up there, and then you just go here. And the mud fruits are right here. Also some slit beans. Again, you don't need a lot because you... Yeah, right, I wanted to listen to that, I love it. We have the green farm, so you don't need to get a lot of them, just a few of them. 2 or 3 or even 1 slit even, because you'll get 2 of them. And then you can start mass producing them in your little base. We have bags of fertilizer right here, in this building, 2 or 3, depending on your luck. And you also have some pumps here, in case you want to get some dirty water. And then, yeah right, not now. No, don't bother me with quest game. Now we can get some extra fertilizer from the Voltec facility. Sorry I'm not speaking so much, but I really want this to be kind of a better exercise, so you can do this while you are listening to the video, or you can just memorize the way to this building. Now, the fertilizer is not that hard to get, but again, if you don't know where to find it, you'll probably waste a lot of time. Yeah, okay, bye. Now, there should be some fertilizer lying around here. I'm busy now, don't bother me. It also depends on your luck. Sometimes you'll find some fertilizer here, sometimes you won't find it. But also, steal it from this store. Okay, don't worry about the gunshots, nothing is happening. Raw fertilizer, that's 1 fertilizer, don't worry if it says raw. Wow, they are sure violent this time. Leave me alone. And you have more facilities like this one. Also, they can give you some nice aluminium scrap. Aluminium is another thing you really need in the game. Okay. Here it is, just go and pick up some more from there. You can also enter the big facility. There's a lot of raw fertilizer in there and a lot of other things, but that's the hard way to do it. And you don't really need a lot of it. Now that you have your fertilizer, mud fruits and corn. Yeah, corn is actually very easy to pick up and you can just go, let me show you, to the Ironhold homestead. Here you'll find corn. Corn, cranberries and potato plants and some other good stuff. I'll just show you where it is and how you get there. The problem with this strategy is that you'll need to do a lot of roads before you set up your production line, because, well, as you saw, I'm using also that perk green farm. And I'm not really the most patient guy. What? Why are they bothering me right now? I'm busy. So, this is actually one of the easiest locations to farm. Because usually I just get some dogs, and the dogs are good meat, are a good source of protein. Now, you go south from his farm. And you have this whole field just for you. Now let me check up my map, because this can be a little bit, I don't know, confusing the first time you get here and you farm. Here we go, those are the cranberries. Come on, dog, leave me alone. Some mutants, some ghouls, so nothing too serious, anyway. And as you can see, there is a lot of cranberries. You can get up to 20 cranberries with the pearl. Okay, and also the corn and the potato plants are somewhere around here. You won't have a lot of problems finding them, but again, here is one. And the others are back there. Well, the game seems to be wanting to feed me a lot, because it's giving me a lot of enemies that I can eat. And you also have this power armor station, which almost all the time has something good for you. I mean, look at this. I actually need this. Nice. So you can actually get some good power armors here. You can actually use that bench to scrap your items, and here you have some ammo, and again, a lot of good stuff can spawn here. So now you have your cranberry location, and now let's head down to the harder part of the game. Now let's see. Yeah, Vault 76 is the next location we need to visit. Don't worry, just pick up some other things on the way, because you will need a lot of things to start your base and to start a good game. Remember, if you're doing this with friends, it will go a lot faster. And you can also help them out. And impressing them with your Fallout knowledge skills. So we're here for... Oh, that was a rat stack though. Well, that almost all the times come here. That's a nice spawn if you can kill it, because you'll get that meat, and I showed you what you can do with that meat. Now we're here for the soot flowers and also the blood leaf. Sometimes you can pick a lot on your way down. I think I skipped a few, but then again, well, I'm not the most patient guy. So if you find a better route down this hill, you can take it. That was the first one. Only some ticks here. I think there was another one. If you follow the trail and not jump over the ledges like I do, like a maniac. There's another one. And now it should be a lot easier to find. Yeah, I jumped a bit too much. That's not what I'm looking for. Nice, so this is the valley where you'll find a lot of them. Just make a big circle around the edges. And that's a soot flower. There will be another one right here. And just search the edges a bit and you'll find a lot more of these. Yeah, as you can see now, you'll probably have a lot. Remember to equip that perk. I'm only saying that because it's very important. The first time I played the game, I didn't know what to do with my plants. Now, as you can see, we pick up a lot of them. And purified water is also a good healing item. In case you're wondering why it's so important to have it in your base. Also, if you do the juices, you'll have some buffs, and again, everything helps here. Nice. Now we'll go for the blood leaf. The blood leaf is actually very easy and very close to this area. Just head southwest. Yeah, well, you can go to this location as well, but not really worth it, in my opinion. Sometimes you can get a steam pack, but it's hard to remember where it is and... No. Were they fighting? Oh, I interrupted them. Okay. So just plan your destination and jump all over the map. If you have the power armor with you, it's even better, or just the chases, the power armor chases. So you won't get damaged from falling. Come on. Jump faster. Are we there? Actually, you'll see when you're there, because there is a little patch of water. And you can also build a base there, because it's also a strategy location. Now, when you're teleporting or fast traveling on the map, remember that Fallout 76, the vault, is a free travel location. A suit floor there. Oh, come on, again. They are hunting me down. Fallout 76 is a free travel, is a free fast travel location. Your base is a fast travel location, which is also free. So use this as a waypoint. Don't spend all your caps on fast travel because you have some other options. And as you see, you can just run if the distance is not that big. I also have the agility perk Marathoner, which will consume less action points when I run. So with these two perks, you can actually, the Green Thumb and the Marathoner, you can actually do this so much faster. You won't even spend a lot of caps, you'll spend only some caps traveling to the farm. Okay, and here we are. It's pretty easy to find this, it's water. And the blood leaves are not that hard to find. And again, with your perk, we will have a lot of them. And also the glowing fungus is here. And there is quite a lot of blood leaves in this area. Again, don't waste your time collecting and doing other stuff. This is the fastest way to get them, and this is the fastest way to start your farming. So, if once you do enemies, oh, bee swarm, okay, I need to get out of there. So once you do this, we have one more location to visit, and this one is actually pretty close by. Come on guys, leave me alone. I am busy. You can go to this one. What? Okay, I heard some gunshots. You can go to this location. You can either go there the second time or now. Doesn't really matter, the order is not important, but we need snaptail reeds from here. And it's not such a hard thing to do. Depending on where you put your base, you can fast travel without spending even a single caps. And then just run a bit of distance, and again, your goal in this game is not actually to farm, but to explore and actually to level up and do the quest and have fun. Okay, we're here. And here you can also find some mud fruits and a lot of cool stuff. Also kill a lot of things and gather some scrap. Some soot flowers are also here. That's not one of them. There are always quests in this area and all those people who are doing something bad. Okay, so to get to the snaptail reeds, you need to follow the stream and go this way. Let's do a bit of jumping so it speeds things up. Let's see where we are. Okay, we need to go this way a bit more. You can also pick up some random plants in the forest, some blackberries. Also some meat from the animals. Well, this is longer than I thought. So you might want to go to Mama Dolce's processing plant and then head south to the 64 sign. Okay, we're almost there. Fast traveling in this game is pretty nice, but again, you might want to equip some perks for that. The hard bargain is also good, and there is also a perk to reduce your fast travel time. Because most people will prefer this method. I mean, you farm a lot, you grind a lot, and then you go on adventures a lot. You don't really want to mix and match everything up. Okay, and here we are. By the way, you might want to equip a hazmat or something better to protect yourself from the water, because again, you'll do a lot of this, see? You'll accidentally drink the water when collecting the snaptails. Just follow the stream down. There we are, another batch. I am not collecting everyone, I'm just showing you how many they are. You won't need this many, but again, better to be safe than sorry, right? Again, see, there are a lot of there, and once you reach this location, there are even more. And even more, if you go even down the stream, there are so many more. Okay, I have collected too much plant life. Let's drink some water and then we can go. And this is why we need a red stag meat and the increased inventory space. You can also use a buff out or other drugs to increase your carrying capacity, because you might run out of space. And now, once the festival is done, I'll show you where to get the gourds, because you'll need the gourds for this one. Come on, here we are. He has to sit down and cook. He can't do it from any direction. Now, you can also do the cranberry cobbler, it gives you 5% experience, but most of the time you'll just go for the cranberry relish. Now, as you can see, we still need the boiled water and the sugar, so sugar is very easy to make. We'll just make a bunch and store it. Okay, I like to make a complete guide all the time. Okay, reload your weapon. So we need two dirty waters. And then you can do a boiled water. And now, to get the gourd, well, that's actually very easy, but it's a very, very distant location. You have to go to Rayleigh Clay's bunker. He has 5 planters with, and there are 5 gourds in there. So you can get 10 gourds, and that's all the gourds you'll ever need. Let me show you again, in case you missed it, because I think this is the only gourd location you can get them. See, and I don't know, you can use this as a point of reference, the top of the world. Now, let's craft that cranberry relish, and when we eat it, we'll end the video. Okay. Oh, I need to boil the water. Oh, come on, game. So you'll need 4 water, 4 dirty waters. Okay. And now let's prepare our cranberry relish. And let's take a little nap. The game has a lot of hidden secrets like this one. I mean, it's not very clear what you have to do, but they made everything count for something. So everything you pick up and everything you have in your inventory can be used for something, especially this farming and this farming the farms or farming the forest. So it's not all about the meat. Actually, the plants based food is better in some ways and can give you a lot of better buffs, and it can actually make your game a lot easier if you're playing alone. If you're playing in a team, it will make it even easier than it is. Come on, we just ate and we had a good sleep. Now let's eat our prize, our big prize. Where are you, cranberry relish? Yummy. Exceptional. Okay, now this is all our buffs, so as you can see there are a lot of them. 5% right there. Potato juice, extra AP. Cranberry relish, 10% experience, that's 15% extra experience. And I don't know, I usually get that item that will give you more experience, that canned food, the canned soup or something. But I guess I ate it all today. Well, this has been the video. If you have any questions, just post them in the comments. Bye bye.